And what's up, guys? It is super early in the morning, 4 a.m. and I'm about to go fishing. Obviously, you're probably wondering why I'm not taking my autopilot. Well, it's because it's really simple. I just haven't received my battery yet from FPV Mariner Cells because of all the and speaking of the whole man, yesterday I went to the grocery store again to try to get some meat and fish, and there was a super long line. I'm talking about at least a hundred people just waiting in line at HEB, and I passed by it and I was like, you know what, forget this. I'm gonna do it the nature way, which is take the kayak out or go get my own harvest. So that's the plan. We're gonna see if we can catch some redfish or flounder for dinner and do a catch and cook for you guys. All right, last time I was at this area, I saw a lot of mullet and a lot of grass shrimp. So let me show you the lures that we're gonna be using today. All right, check it out, fellas. This is rig number one. This is my medium action old 18 hollow point with the hydra bug from Bugs Lure Fishing Lures. This is a bigger lure. This should be able to target and be a nice looking bait, a presentation to the big redfish that are in this area. So I'm looking forward to throwing this. And as I just mentioned, we did see a lot of grass shrimp. So I have the hothead here paired up with my ultralight with the Shimano. So this thing is gonna be a more finesse type rig. If the big baits don't work, we'll go to the shrimp looking imitation and we'll be able to hopefully pound them. The flounder especially would like this right here. And last but not least, since we saw a lot of mullet, we can't go wrong with the paddle tail, a dark color bass color from Bio Baits. This is the paddle tail. This is a good mullet imitation. I have this on a light action rod. So let's see if we can get some groceries today and make my family happy. You guys stay tuned. All right, we got overcast conditions, gentlemen. We had a lot of rain, so it was very flooded here. But we're gonna try our best to see if we can get some dinner. As I said, I ain't willing to wait 2 hours in line at HEB, but I am willing to fish for 8 hours for one fish. It's, I would say, at least 2 feet higher than what I remember. All right, so being deep, you know what? I think I wanna try a heavier bait. We're gonna go with the heavier lure. The water's a little bit murky too. It's brackish. So we'll see if we can get a fish on this heavier lure so it dives down deeper and faster. So the game plan, guys, like I said, is just work the shoreline all the way down as far as we can. Just fish the drop-offs, as you guys always hear me say. I mean, that's a really good game plan when you have this much water and you really don't know what to expect. As we are moving pretty fast, this current is moving from that rain for the past day and a half or so. I want to fish as slow as possible so I'm able to hit the ground and perhaps grab a flounder if they're here in this, I would say, majority fresh water now. Today might be a grind, folks, considering how much fresh water we have, how flooded it is. I don't see any bait at all, which is really concerning to me. And in order to catch fish, guys, you know you have to have bait. All right, nothing doing with this. Let's change out to something a little bit more smaller profile. Let's see if we can get them to bite. There we go. That's a red. That's a red. Yep, that's a redfish. I don't think he's gonna be a keeper though. No, what? Are you joking me? What is it? It's a freaking gaff top. Oh my god.
Are you kidding?
I'm not joking, dude. I don't make these things up, man.
That's a big ass gaff top.
Dude, he like semen all over my line too. Oh my god. All right, get out of here. Golly, that is nasty. There we go. That's a fish. Oh crap, a trout. No way. Speckled trout.
Really?
Yeah, that's a first. I didn't think they were here, but they are. All right, check it out, guys. He's not a keeper, but
man, I figured this intersection would have
nice speckled trout. Small guy, here you go. Yeah, there's a lot of bait hanging out right at the flat. me catching that salt, that trout tells me, okay, the salt water should be a little better here. So maybe we'll get lucky here. Oh, there we go. I just got thumped. Yeah, I'm getting thumped. Something's pulling it. Small guys. That's a yeah, that's a flounder, bro. You got him. Nice. Oh, that's a good flounder. Hold on, let me help you. Oh my God, that's a good flounder. Nice, Marcus. Finally, someone's catching fish. Marcus is the one that found this little drop off with bait all over the place. You got a net?
That's a big boy.
Oh my, oh, it's a red.
Shit.
That's a big red. All right, you got him. You got him. You got him.
Oh, my fucking paddle.
That's a slot, bro.
Yeah.
Good job. Good job.
Oh, finally.
There we go. That's a flounder. Small little potato chip on the hothead. Nice. I knew they're here somewhere. Just got to upgrade from this potato chip to a bigger one. Appreciate it. Oh, come on, brother. Small little dude. Give me my lure back here. Nice little. Later, bud. On the hothead, it's working. A hothead's kind of like your last resort, last woo-ha-ha, I guess, per se. Try to catch these flounder. Just what I'm doing is letting it bounce all the way down. Letting it hit, trying to about 3 feet down. Just kind of twitching it slowly and reeling in slowly. Try to get something to bite it. There we go. That's a fish. That's a fish. That's a flounder. Another small little potato chip. I take them though. Yeah, the hothead is coming through, man. What a savior. I used pretty much every lure that I pretty much almost had, and the hothead has been the one that's been delivering the small little shrimp imitation. Nice little flounder here, boy. All right, ladies and gents, real quick update. There's really not much of an update. I went pretty much halfway down this creek all the way towards the end, and I decided to turn it back around because of wind. I mean, I was able to hook into what, three small fish, couple flounder, one trout. It's tough, man. I think has a lot to do with the wind conditions, but more so all the fresh water that came in from the day and a half of rainfall. Yeah, it's the water level is much higher than I remember, and yeah, it's amazing how you can go to one place and just freaking tear it up, and then a few days later you go and it's absolutely a different monster, meaning it just turned off. So we're gonna go back and I'm gonna keep fishing the shoreline, and hopefully we'll be able to catch a fish. There we go. That's a red. There we go. There we go. Got him on a drop. Let's loosen up that drag. Yeah, he's a keeper. Finally able to catch something, but we can't talk too soon. We haven't got him into the boat yet. Yes, hopefully this guy will be my groceries, the meat. And look, he is just taking me. Oh my God, he's taking me on me a ride. Loosen up the drag just a little bit more so we don't break that line. Oh my God, this is a big guy. Wow, he is pulling a lot of drag, you know, but this is an ultralight, so you know, a lot of things seem like it's bigger than it is. Let's take that drive up just in case. Oh, there he is. That's a big red. I just saw him. Oh my God. Oh, that's a beautiful redfish. That's a beautiful red. Come on in. Gotcha. Woo! Yes. And he dragged me all the way into the grass, guys. Look at that. 24 and a quarter inch. He's gonna make a good eating redfish. Man, I'm telling you what, I am one lucky son of a gun to be able to catch this monster, this beautiful 24 incher. He's gonna make a nice dinner for my family, man. Caught him on the curl tail coming back to the launch. Hard day. 24 incher. I'm so ecstatic. Man, words cannot explain, folks. I mean, it's been a freaking grinder. Thank you, dude. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, it was a tough day in the beginning, but salvaged the day with a nice big redfish. And as I promised you guys, we're gonna do a catch and go. Check it out. I got her ice down. Check her out right there. Look at that. I got her bled out. She is good to go. I'm super excited because this redfish, man, if you don't know it, man, meat and fish, they go for a lot of money these days. And I'm at the grocery store or the gas station here, and some guys pulled up, say they wanted to buy my fish for 75 bucks. Can you believe that? I'm like, well, I gotta feed my family, so that's that. But thank you guys so much for watching. It was a grind, but we made through it, man. This COVID-19 is a grind, but we're gonna make through it. And yes, we're gonna do a catch and cook, but as you guys probably know, or you didn't know, my wife has started her own cooking channel. It's called Simple Dish. We're gonna take this redfish right here and we're gonna take it to her channel and she's gonna cook it. So you guys check her out. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment on her video. You know, the wife wants to do some cooking stuff and she has a lot of skills. I think you guys will really enjoy her videos because I edited them all. So show the support, man. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll catch you guys on the next one.